You know what, actually, I'm going to start walking backwards because I want to actually just kind of walk. Whoa, check out the art wall there. Pretty cool stuff. That's what I love about this, like, being around Brooklyn. You know, there's so much community here that is just begging to be seen. Anyway, so much community and culture. Anyway, so I'm walking backwards just to kind of tread my path that I usually take when I'm going to Manhattan or going to tutor. Usually a lot of my students that I tutored were toward Brooklyn area. I mean, toward Manhattan area, not upwards towards Brooklyn. I only had two students that were living upwards, like farther up in Brooklyn than me. So I'm gonna tread my path back, and it's gonna be interesting because I do have quite a, I have some buildings, like there's a humongous grocery store there. It's called Bazaar Foods, and my roommates and I go there quite often. I don't like going there just because I don't like supporting humongous chains. I usually just get my produce and stuff from like corner stores like these, just support the little guys, and also because it's cheaper. Or there's also a produce store down a little further down this block that's really good because it's so ridiculous cheap. But the quality of the produce sometimes is not so good over there. But it's tiny. There's no lines to wait or something like that. So definitely going back to this path. And you know, doing this experience actually puts my neighborhood in a new light to me. You know, I always enjoyed here, but definitely being able to show this off to the rest of the world has set some meaning too. Definitely, it's a beautiful little place. It feels quaint. It still feels like New York City, even though it's really kind of a more, it's a little bit more suburban than urban, I guess. Definitely, this part of New York City, it's a lot helpful if you have a car. Although there are train stations like 3 blocks away, which is what I usually take. There's the L and the M station on the Myrtle Wyckoff, which is where I'm going to be heading to. I'm going to be heading to the train station here. And we're back to my apartment over there, which is great. Right across over there, the building in the far, far, far ahead, that's the the takeout fast food Chinese restaurant that my roommates frequent. Before I turned vegan, I used to go there quite a lot too, but there's nothing I can eat there. When I immediately turned vegan, I actually had their general sauce tofu, but that apparently is something I can't eat too because they put the orange sauce that they use to make the general sauce tofu is made. It contains fish sauce, which is made from which contains anchovies. So definitely not vegan. Definitely can't eat it. So I can't eat anything there now. But maybe except like vegetable lo mein or something like that. But before I turned vegan, it was usually a really good, cheap, kind of a fast foody place to just take food and eat. But now I know better. Now I take a little bit of time anyway. I mean, waiting for food to be prepared and coming here and calling and waiting for food, it takes about the same time as cooking your meal yourself. So I figure, why bother with that? Anyway, so going this way. There's two ways to go about going to the train station. There's this way down here. So I could take all the way down here and go to turn right on Palmetto. And then there's a train station here. But I really like taking this path because it's just straight and straight. So this path is just go straight down to Myrtle, I believe. It's either Myrtle or Wyckoff. I forget the street names because I'm just so now used to just walking the path and being used to that. But this path down here, and then take a left at Myrtle or Wyckoff, and then just go straight down to the train station. But I'm going down this path also because I want to show a building, a store that I encountered during as a tutor. It's an educational building. It sells educational products for educators. And it's a really great place. It helped me out a lot when I first started as a tutor. You know, one of my biggest challenges as a tutor was mentoring this kindergartner, which I did make a YouTube video about way back, like a month ago. But I had no materials to teach anything with, and I just went there and had a good conversation with the store manager there. And she provided with me a lot of stuff, and I got 10% discount for being a tutor, even though I couldn't prove that I was a tutor or whatever, because I don't have like a tutor business card. But it's a really cool place. There's, of course, the stuff there is really over, like really expensive, but I guess that's because it's local. It's not a chain store, so they can't mass produce and, you know, get stuff like at bulk for cheap prices. So the prices make sense, but it is a place that I love supporting. I wish I had a more bigger source of income too, and I wish I could just, you know, tutor kids for free, so that, I mean, I do tutor kids for free pretty much because I tutor for a nonprofit organization, but the company actually pays me $15 an hour, so that's the thing. So here's a corner store. Right next to corner store is the educational store. It's the Learning Curve. See that right there? It's closed right now. But it's a quaint little store with educational supplies. It's a great store, I think. It has a lot of neat products, a lot of kid products. I bought a whiteboard there that is portable, and it contains like a placeholder for markers and eraser board. It's really neat. And beneath the whiteboard, you can take the whiteboard out. It's a clear plastic thing, and you can switch it to different things. Like there's ones that are designed for. There's one that are designed for like kindergartners who are learning alphabets. So there's like a line and a squiggly line in the middle so they can practice their writing and stuff like that. This is the Food Bazaar. It's a humongous grocery store. It has pretty much everything that you could ever want from a grocery store. Don't really recommend going there all too often, but if I guess for those situations where you're just like, oh, I want to go to one place and just shop, you know, for everything, that's the place to go. I also like this. I also went to this store a lot, 99 cent store right there. I bought an umbrella there for $2.30. That's a ridiculous price. Like, I'm guessing it's that cheap because it's probably like from exploded, like, you know, it was probably made from China and workers were probably paid like a penny per a day or something like that. I don't know, but the umbrella was super cheap. It was a rainy day. I think I had a job interview that day, so I had to quickly get it because I usually don't mind rain, but me being in a suit and tie and not being wanting to wet, so I got it. And that umbrella has lasted me to this day. Actually, last 2 weeks ago, I went to my friend's birthday party. I usually sling my umbrella, the tail of the umbrella, I usually hook it to my jean pocket or my coat pocket or whatever, so I don't really have to carry it or whatever. But apparently I dropped it somewhere, and I didn't realize that I lost it until like later when we were at a club or something. I was like, oh shoot, where's my $2.30 umbrella? So like I figured it's lost, but on our walk back home, I found it on the street, and I picked it up and was like, wow, this is destiny. This umbrella and me, we're destined to be together. So that's the umbrella story. It's a pretty, I don't know, it's a flimsy umbrella. I mean, it's a cheap umbrella. Like, if the wind blows alert a little too hard, it just flips over. But that's something I've encountered with all umbrellas, actually. I haven't actually ever owned a good umbrella. This is the train station, Myrtle Wyckoff Station here. It's pretty nice, I guess. It's, I think, pretty much the biggest station in like this part of Brooklyn, and it's like the only station I could count on. The M goes above ground, which is nice, but the M is very slow to come, and the L goes below ground. L train is one of the most efficient trains ever, but this weekend, yesterday and today, L trains aren't running, so this bus. It's actually going to substitute the L train line, and when buses substitute train lines, that's just horrible. It's not as horrible here because that's going to Brooklyn, but that bus right there, that's going to Manhattan, that bus is going to be crowded and it's just going to be awful. So I'm gonna go down this way. Toward Manhattan I go, I guess. I haven't really planned out my route or path that I'm going to take or anything. But, yeah. So this is my journey. I started recording this video because actually I wanted to tweet. Right after, you know, going out of the department, I wanted to tweet my adventure officially starts. But Twitter on my iPhone, currently, I don't know, maybe it works now, but it wasn't working. You know, I was hitting like, I wanted to tweet, but it wasn't accessing the internet for some reason. I have no idea why, so definitely after this recording, I'm gonna check that out.